Hey, this is Phil, and it's your Friday video update. Well, Happy New Year. You know, it's hope you all had a great holiday season, but now it's 2015 and the market's hot right now and it's time to get back to work. And couldn't have been better timing. Interest rates have also improved here recently. Another unexpected improvement in interest rates, but something that a lot of people are taking advantage of. I know a lot of agents are busy writing contracts and customers are taking advantage of the great rates. So I think we're off to a super fantastic 2015, and I'm looking forward to a great year. I wanted to give you some quick updates on two things that came out this week, and frankly, I'm recording this email for the second time, and I'm doing that because when I previously recorded, shortly after finishing it, wouldn't you know, we got a letter from FHA to formally announce what had been reported yesterday, that they were going to be lowering their monthly mortgage insurance premium. Well, lo and behold, they've done it. So the monthly mortgage insurance premiums on 30-year fixed FHA loans have been lowered by 0.5%. So a 3.5% down FHA loan where you used to pay 1.35% in monthly mortgage insurance is now down to 0.85%. And the good news is that you can actually refinance a client as long as their FHA loan was taken out after, I think it's May 1st of 2009, and take advantage of the lower new 0.85 mortgage insurance premium. And any contracts that are currently under contract and in process, there is actually a way to re-request a new FHA case number that will then allow them to take advantage of the new lower monthly mortgage insurance premium. So if you have any clients that are under contract and happen to be working with another lender, please make sure that that lender cancels their case number and reissues a case number so that your clients can take advantage of the new lower FHA mortgage insurance premiums. It does not apply to 15-year loans or less, so just FYI. The other big announcement that I wanted to make sure that you all are aware of is this. There, starting January 26th, oh, and by the way, those case numbers and the premiums are also active as of January 26th. But starting January 26th, lenders are now being required to submit their appraisals to a new online system through Fannie Mae called CU, or Collateral Underwriter, and it's basically another electronic version or valuation of an appraisal, and we don't know exactly what this is going to mean, but we do know it's another step in the process that they've decided is important and that we're going to be obliged to have to take care of. And they've also put, I guess, a lot of this is going to fall on appraisers. But there is another step in the process, and I'm not really sure whether or not this is going to have a big impact or a small impact, but it's certainly something else to be concerned with or at least be aware of. So I will give you more information on that as it becomes available. And one more thing that I wanted to start getting the word out about is this. In August of 2015, there is going to be a requirement that is going to be in place that lenders are going to have HUD-1s and the complete closing package done 3 days in advance of settlement. And if there are any changes at all to that HUD-1, then there's going to be a delay because there's a 3-day requirement once the HUD-1 is completed. So the first thing that comes to mind for me is, what about home inspections and adjustments and last minute realtor credits and all that kind of stuff? Well, quite frankly, I'm not sure how the real estate industry is going to handle this, but I can tell you right now, you're going to start hearing about it. And I'm just going to get out in front of this a little bit and give you a little inside information, and you're going to want to start talking to your brokers and start kind of keeping your eyes and ears open about information and how the industry is going to handle this, because it is going to be important. We at First Heritage are on top of this. We're starting to put systems and processes in place to manage this on our end. But the real estate industry is going to have to address it too with home inspections and the last minute changes to HUDs and things like that are going to delay settlement 3 days. So I'm not trying to be an alarmist here. I'm just trying to make you aware of what's coming in August. We're planning on getting some information together and more than likely having a seminar, possibly even a seminar / webinar. But you'll get word on that when it happens. But I want my partners to be educated and to understand what it means and start to develop business practices that are going to take care of this so that nobody suffers. So that's it for today. I hope you find that good information. Please remember to share and forward this information to any other real estate agent or business partner you think might find it helpful. And I'm always here to answer questions and certainly always here to help you with any clients that you may have. Have a great week, and I will talk to you again soon.